हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश 10 क्लासेस एक्सरसाइज 17. गेट रेडी फॉर द डिक्टेशन. स्टार्ट. सर, आई एक्सप्रेस माय ग्रेटिट्यूड टू द ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स फॉर द कीन इंटरेस्ट दे हैड टेकन इन द होल मैटर एंड फॉर द मैनी वैल्यूएबल सजेशंस दे हैव मेड. Unfortunately, in the limited time at my disposal, I will not be able to refer to every point which has been raised by the honorable members, but I can assure the House through you that all the suggestions which have been made will be given full consideration by the government. I would like to take up some common points which have been stressed by a very large number of my honorable friends here. The first point that has been stressed by a very large number of members deals with the question of the care of expectant mothers and the care and particularly the nutritional care of smaller children up to the age of 6. There is no doubt that this is the most important period in the life of any human being, and any lack of effort in this age group can have very serious consequences when the child grows into adulthood. For this purpose, Education Ministry, in close collaboration with the Ministry of Health, Agriculture and obviously with the cooperation of the state governments, has started the Integrated Child Development Services, which aim at all these points that have been emphasized. The concept of Integrated Child Development Services has been explained by us before, but I would crave your indulgence to explain again in a few minutes. The main concept of the Integrated Child Development Services. It starts with the question of nutrition and health care of expectant mothers. Then there is a full-fledged program of immunization, which certainly includes the triple vaccines. Along with this, there is the question of regular health check up, referral services, nutrition supplementing measures and the diet and preschool and formal and informal education. We consider it absolutely essential that children of the age group 3 to 6 and particularly those belonging to the weaker sections of the community should be provided with such care so that they can develop proper attitudes and motivations, and also their character formation is influenced in a healthy direction. For this purpose, we propose to set up centers as far as possible in close proximity of a primary school to involve elder children, especially girls to participate in the looking after of the younger babies as a part of their work experience. It would provide them with adequate training to learn about how to look after children and younger babies. It would also provide assistance to the center's workers and a full-fledged training program the workers have to undertake. Because this was a new scheme and because it involved the cooperation of a very large number of agencies, it was felt that let the systems be worked out in a small number of blocks, and we have chosen 35 blocks. 20 of these are rural blocks, 10 are in tribal areas, and 5 in urban slums. This program is being tried out, and government would like to expand this scheme to a very large number of other blocks so that we are able to cover, hopefully by the 9th plan period, every block in the country. This is an important scheme whereby the problems of the rural children and the children belonging to the weaker sections of the community would be looked after from the point of view of health, from the point of view of immunization, and from the point of view of what may be called preschool education or attitude formation and so on. This program, I am glad to say, has evoked proper response from all the ministries of the Government of India and most of the state governments. We felt that an independent agency to monitor this scheme would be extremely useful. For this purpose, we invited the medical colleges, and I am glad to say that 27 medical colleges have responded to our invitation. The All India Institute of Medical Sciences in New Delhi is coordinating the work that is being done by the medical colleges for preparing the baseline data about nutrition, about the general health of children and of expectant mothers, and so on. It would also be supervising the implementation of the scheme in other respects, so that along with the administrative setup which is looking after this program, there is also an independent organization which can monitor and which can provide expert guidance for the implementation of this particular program. We have also insisted that in each village there should be women organization formed, because without involvement of the women of the villages and the localities concerned, no worthwhile program for children is likely to succeed. The progress so far in this regard has been on the whole satisfactory, although I would like greater emphasis being placed by the state government on the setting up of women organizations in each of the villages. The state governments are anxious to set up these organizations as early as possible. Stop.